I'd like to thank AGI, the sponsors and fellow presenters, and my fellow participants for giving me the opportunity to talk about some of my favorite things, which are rocks for infrastructure. Rocks are really crucial for infrastructure because one lane, 1 mile of road takes 38,000 tons of rock. These sources need to be local because rocks are very heavy and costly to transport. If you go over 30 miles, it doubles the cost of the material, so you need a lot where it's needed. And finally, geology impacts the quality of the road. I'll try not to use too much jargon, but one expression is aggregates, which are simply stone, sand, or gravel that are used for construction. A couple of the resources that I'm using are come from U.S. Geologic Survey, their Minerals Information Series, and also the Federal Highway Administration has a very fancifully titled paper called Wherefore Out There Art Thou Aggregate Resources for Highways, which I use some of the their information in this presentation. Also, on the NSSJ website, we have an aggregate map which uses some of the USGS information if you're interested in aggregates in your state. I love quarries. I consider them windows to geology. I realize not everyone else has that same interest, but the process of getting rocks to roads, at least at the rock stage, is fairly simple. There's no chemicals used or produced. Basically, naturally occurring rock is crushed and sorted. The industry is heavily regulated. There are permits and requirements before, during, and after operations. Some of the questions folks ask, particularly if quarries are in their area, are why are there so many? Why are they so big? And why are they here? And the answer to all of these is geology. There are about 10,000 aggregates operations in the U.S., and you can see their location on the lower green map. And you can tell that these are located in population centers and also follow the location of highways and roads. This is because, again, costs go up exponentially with distance. Quarries need to be large for safety and efficiency reasons. Equipment and permits are expensive, so you need scale. Also, you have to have room to have barriers, setbacks, and a terraced entryway for safety. While stone, sand, and gravel are common, quality material near where it's needed is not. Generally, there are four types of aggregates resources, and their general location is shown in the colorful upper map. Trap rock, which is the black rock, is volcanic and tends to be located in the west, mainly the Pacific Northwest. Granite tends to be located in eroded mountain areas and is shown on the map in green. Unconsolidated or loose sand and gravel river deposits tend to be located around river deposits and are shown in yellow. And limestone, which is the white rock, is located all over the U.S., but mainly big deposits are located in the Midwest, the Southeast, and the Southwest. Limestone makes great roads, but also has lots of other uses. You've probably eaten this if you've had a Tums. And basically, all of the industrial purposes are similar to what Tums does, which is a neutralization. So it's used to clean air and scrubbers and for power plants, and also to treat water and wastewater. All the rocks have really different properties, and the road mixes or the road construction takes these into account. So how does a rock turn into a road? Well, first, a geologist looks at U.S. Geologic Survey maps and other information to find a good source of aggregate. Then they do extensive testing, and that is looking for an extensive deposit that is enough for a large, long-used quarry, and also that the properties will go into a mix and make a good road. A mix is basically a recipe for a road that the state departments of transportation have developed, and these are based on available sources and traffic and weather. No one size fits all for a good road. A place like Dallas is going to have a much different road than rural Maine. There's extensive research testing and looking at roads' performance, and geologists work to keep up on these standards to make sure that they have the good product that goes into a good road. Basically, aggregates make up 80 to 90% of road, whether you're talking about asphalt or concrete. So it's basically the rock plus a glue to hold it together. In the case of asphalt, it's petroleum. In the case of concrete, it's cement to hold it together. An example, I'm going to go into land use and long-term benefit of quarries. And the first example that I'm going to use is Luckstone Quarry. If you're a resident of the DC area or live or work around DC, you've probably seen this quarry. It's just northwest of the Dulles Airport. So if you fly in or out, you see this large hole in the ground. Or if you are a biking enthusiast, you might have used the Old Dominion and Washington Bike Trail, which is a former railroad, which actually bisects the quarry. This quarry, they don't actually know how old it is. They know that it was in operation before the Civil War. It helped build the railroad, the former railroad that was in the area, as well as all the roads in the area. You can see from the lower aerial photo that there's a lot of competing land use in the area. You have homes to the east, you have farmland and parks to the west, quite close. You end up having a lot of houses built near quarries after the quarries in operation because it's a lot more economic to build where you have materials nearby. But you can see this may create some problems as the quarry continues to operate. When the quarry is played out, one of the uses is to become a reservoir, and that's what's going to happen with the north part of the quarry. The local community is going to use this for a reservoir to supply water, and I believe that my fellow presenter, Brian's company, is helping to work on this. What else can a quarry become? Well, it can become a beautiful park. This is the Boboli Gardens in Florence, which the material was used to help build the buildings and the roads in the area, and now it's a park. In the U.S., it may become a wildlife habitat or a golf course. On the top left, you have what's known as the Chambers Bay Championship Golf Course. This was a quarry for about 100 years, providing material to help build Seattle. On the right, you have the Bellwood Quarry, which is located in Atlanta. You might have seen this on TV. It was used in The Walking Dead and also the movie The Hunger Games. This is a disused quarry, but it's going to become a reservoir with 1 million gallons of water to supply for the city of Atlanta. To fill this, they're going to have to drill through the rock to get to the Chattahoochee River. They need a very large drill bit to do this, and to get the community excited about this project, they had a contest to name the actual drill bit that's being used, and the local community voted to name the drill bit after the rapper Killer Mike, and he's become a really great spokesman for this project. So hopefully through this quick presentation, you've seen that rocks are really important for infrastructure, that geology helps determine the quality of the road. You really need good rocks to make a good road, and that quarries can perform a long-term benefit. And I believe all questions will be held to the end. Thanks.